Hey guys, what's up? I would like to officially introduce you to my series for National Recovery Month, which is all of September, in case you weren't aware. And this series is pretty undefined at this point. I am going to share stories of recovery, which, surprise, surprise, not too far from my original content. I'm interested in sharing stories outside of mine. So if you are interested in possibly joining me and sharing, email me at meganeff@gmail.com. Otherwise, sit back and watch. I'm planning on doing stories of people in the treatment field, in addiction, in recovery, maybe family members of addicts. I got some things planned. We'll see how it goes. But today's video is going to be inspired by the slogan of National Recovery Month, which is R is for recovery. So R is for recovery made my little brain think ABCs of recovery. Yay! Before I go too much further, let me give you a brief intro if you're new here. My name is Megan. I am a recovering addict and I've been on this 11-year journey of recovery. I am also about to officially start my career as a drug and alcohol counselor. Yay! I'm so excited if you can't tell. I can't believe this is happening. Before I get into today's video, can you like this video and subscribe? Definitely subscribe if you want some more recovery content, because I don't upload regularly, I'm sorry, but I'm going to be putting out a good bit of videos about this month. So yeah, like this video, subscribe, turn the bell notification on, yeah, so you get notified, and comment down your ABCs, or if you feel so inspired, do this yourself. Seriously, do it. Let's get into this. A is for attitude. Attitudes determine your behaviors, and your behaviors rule your life, obviously. So I try to choose an attitude of gratitude, as cliche as that is, an attitude of humility. Humbleness. I don't know, that didn't sound right. An attitude of positivity, an attitude of kindness, an attitude of open-mindedness. B is for balance. I try to maintain a level of balance, especially in like my work-life balance, because I have learned that if I let that slip out of whack, like everything falls apart quickly. My mental health does not handle that well. And balance just makes my recovery journey so much easier. C is for challenge. I challenge myself constantly. I challenge myself to face my fear of failure. I challenge myself to put myself out there. I challenge complacency. I challenge boredom. D is for define. I have defined my individualized recovery goals, and I have not used like your stereotypical goals. I have defined them to fit what works for me, and that has been so key to my success. E, establish healthy boundaries. I do not think I ever knew what boundaries were, to be quite honest. I mean, you think that they exist and that people will just accept them and respect them from the gate, but it does not work like that. And I have learned that establishing these boundaries makes me feel so much better, makes my relationship so much more healthy, and everything is just so much more fulfilling. F is for forgiveness. I have learned to forgive myself, forgive others. I have learned to ask for forgiveness, and I have learned to accept the apologies that I never got. I forgive the people that never even apologized. G is for good enough. I am good enough. And I have learned to accept good enough. My work is good enough. My house is good enough. Everything is good enough, because you can always be better and do more and try harder. But it's important to have goals, but you have to be realistic. It's time to let go of that perfection, because nothing is perfect. H, holistic approach. I truly have a biopsychosocial model for recovery. So what that means is I consider the dynamic relationship between biological factors, social factors, and psychological factors. I is for incarceration, because your girl went to jail and I did 7.5 months on work release, 4 months house arrest, and it was the catalyst for me entering recovery. J is for journey, because recovery is not a destination, it is a journey. K, knowledge is power. And with that power, you can make educated choices. Getting my psychoeducation or studying psychology really, really shifted the way that I viewed recovery and my role in it, honestly. And it gave me such a better understanding of myself and others and just why we act the way we do. L is for locus of control. And essentially, locus of control is either external or internal. You either view like things happen to you in life, you know, it's luck, it's fate, it's out of your control, or you are responsible for your life. Your choices matter. You have an influence on your future. You have power. I choose to have an internal locus of control more so than an external, because yeah, it's easy to think like, oh, that was just lucky. Oh, that was fate. Like, no, girl, I worked hard for this. I busted my butt over many years for this. I have earned this. I've manifested this. Like, I made this. M is for medication, or Megan, but mostly medication, and mostly medication-assisted treatment, which is Suboxone for me, but for others that could be methadone, Vivitrol, even cannabis now. But I also include my other mental health medications in there because treating my actual diagnoses has made my life so much easier. N, non-linear. Healing is not linear. Recovery is not linear. There is no one path that fits everyone. And it's not a straight line. It sometimes you go up, down, backwards, sideways, like you just have to go with the flow. Just keep going. That's the important part. O is for open communication. I try to maintain open and honest communication in all of my relationships. Now you do have to be respectful and not just be a blunt a-hole, but try to maintain honesty. O could also stand for open arms, which is going to be my new place of employment soon. P is for process. Recovery is a process, and the process is all about progress and not perfection. Q, question. I questioned a lot on my recovery journey. I questioned the status quo. I questioned what was your stereotypical recovery journey. I questioned why this and why that and why not this and why not that. And I have been able to develop this eclectic approach that I am very proud of because it works for me. R is for recovery, obviously. S is for support system, and I have been very blessed to have an amazing support system, but not everyone is. And I think it's important that we do take the time to build a support system. I have extended my support system beyond my family because, you know, I was very lucky to have a family support system as soon as I got out of jail. But I've made sure to include like mentors and teachers and friends into my support system. I have a very strong support system. T is for therapy. I cannot preach highly enough about therapy. Talk therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy, couples therapy, I've done it all, individual therapy, group therapy, drug and alcohol therapy. Seriously, get yourself some therapy. U, unconventional and unafraid. I have gone against the grain a little bit. I don't want to say that I'm like this rebel leading a cause or something. I'm just speaking up for the people that aren't following conventional recovery journeys. And it works. And I'm not afraid to speak about that anymore. I used to be very afraid to share this because I didn't feel like I fit in anywhere. V, vulnerability. By making myself vulnerable on YouTube especially, but just in my life, by opening up and sharing those like really intimate details of my life, I have been able to grow from them. And especially on YouTube, I have been able to turn them into teaching moments to help other people maybe not make the same mistakes that I did. And that has been so empowering. W, worth it. I'm worth it. Life is worth it. Recovery is worth it. I have just built this self-worth inside of me that is so amazing, and I didn't feel that before. I hated myself when I was in active addiction. I genuinely hated myself before active addiction too. And now I feel my worth, and I love that. X is a tricky one, so X is for exclusivity. Recovery should never be exclusive. It should be inclusive. And you often hear me preach about inclusive recovery. What that means is just accepting everybody, allowing everybody into my recovery circle, community. I don't really know what you want to call us. You're my recovery family. And I allow everybody here as long as you're trying to better yourself. And I don't try to dictate what your recovery goals are or what your recovery should look like. Abstinence-based or not, 12 steps or not, smart recovery or not. Everyone is welcome here because inclusive recovery is the way that it should be. There should be no exclusions in recovery. No barriers. No unnecessary barriers. I just don't... Why? Why is for YouTube and the amazing online recovery community that I found. You guys were the missing piece to my recovery journey. I didn't realize that I was missing anything, honestly, and when I started my channel, I did it to advocate, I guess. I did it because I was feeling guilty. I was feeling guilty that I was alive and I was not struggling. And I felt like I owed the world something. I honestly don't know how to explain it other than that. It was Christmas and I was bummed out because I still had so many people that were in active addiction struggling and so many people that I had lost. And I felt lucky, but guilty. So I started sharing and you guys started coming, and you have filled a hole in my heart that I didn't know could be filled. And I am so appreciative of you. Like, I say recovery community, but like, this is my YouTube recovery family. And Z, finally, Z is for Zero Fox, which you would get if you watch my On Wednesdays We Wear Orange shirts, but seriously, I give zero Fs. I am proud and happy, and I will advocate about this, and I will be vocal, and I will stand up for what's right, and I am going to bring change. I am so happy that I have started this channel. I'm so happy I've started this entire journey, seriously. But that's it for my ABCs of recovery. I might do a more generic ABCs of recovery and kind of talk about, you know, what everybody's ABCs could look like. But seriously, if you feel inspired, do this. I would love to see yours. If not, at least write them out in the comments. I would love to read them too. That's all I have for today. I have a couple good videos coming up in store. Like I said, if you're interested in sharing your story with me or with my channel, email me at meganeff@gmail.com, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.